welcome back to Vampyr. We have committed murder, and we are happy to try and get past that flamethrower guy, wherever the hell he is. I actually completely forgot. We can hopefully find him. Let's see if we can do anything here. We could make some fatigue, but 5 I think is fine for now. Cold, bronchitis, pneumonia. We need headache. Migraine, headache, neuralgia. Haven't seen that one yet. Hopefully we can find out the headache one soon. Used revolver. Yeah, Milton shotgun. Best shotgun. I don't even know if it's the only shotgun I have. Dragonbane. See what we have here. Need one more. Damn shame. How's the shotgun? Need lots more good trigger parts. Level 15. Pretty good. Let's go find Sean Hampton, shall we? East End. Oh, Western Docks. Oh, he's over here, huh? Okay, what's this? An unknown event happened. Well, let's go find out what event that was. That's rather odd. Got a custom marker down. Why do we have... There we go. Let's go see what this is. This way is the best way to go. Yeah, poor old Thelma. R.I.P. An unknown event. I wonder what this is. Oh, we did have something happen in the morgue. Oh, where the body's hidden, right. Ergotamine, nice. Looks like potassium permanganate, very nice. Looks like we have some loot to get. I think that just leads outside. There's probably some enemies about. Is this the body? No, but there's a watch. Hmm. I'm a bit nervous walking around here. This is that. I thought this entire floor was covered in blood. It is just a sort of red tinge, so we're okay. That was a bit spooky. Lots of potassium permanganate and ergotamine. These ambient sounds are so scary. Hello? Anyone home? Did we really miss all of that loot on the first run? When we first came here? I didn't like that sound. Oh, hello. Level 10. Oh. Oh, look at this stamina increase. I feel a lot stronger, that's for sure. Ferrous tartrate.
It's locked, alright.
Codeine, ooh. Rarely get codeine. Nice. Can't go in there. Yeah. example. Might be able to analyze that. Maybe not, though. Right, I think we go downstairs now. Yep. Nice miss. Oh, that delay afterwards is nasty. Bonjour. Definitely been here before, but we seem to be able to loot everything, almost things again, which is good. I like stuff. Boop. Always gotta be on the lookout. Where the entrance is. We went this way, that way. So what are we missing? We're looking for the body. For the body that the killer left. But I can't seem to find it. Maybe it's through here. Oh. Alright, let's do this. Ooh, okay. What? I dodged. Oh well. Try again. That guy's tough. Those guys you can kill, they're not that tanky, but my god, they hit hard. Thomas Elwood. Turned into a beast. That isn't... It is him. We are facing the repercussion of our own actions. This game is insane. Hello, sir. Please die. Farm up some blood before we face him again. Took a hit. So we heal up. great service. Can't underestimate the little guys. That is a big mistake to make. To have some lifesteal. To the end of the corridor. Hello, Thomas. Take it easy. Class, buddy. Not so am I. Oh God. I am now. I cannot die. Oh, believe me, you can. Oh God, I'm so. Made a few mistakes. Cannot run out of stamina. That is the killer. If you run out of stamina. Save that for the heal. Save that for the heal. Attacks take stamina too.
We are
shit
now. Broken and monstrous.
Dodge the next attack. Fuck. Oh, I didn't die. I did die. I didn't die. I did die. Okay, third time lucky. We can do this. Did this to ourselves. So we can get out of this ourselves. I got 5 XP for dying. I'll take it. Hello, sir, would you please give me your blood? Why did I do this? I can't do that. I can't go through doors when I'm in a fight. I have to kill them. You left me no choice. Collect, collect, collect. Okay. Thomas Elwood. Hello, sir. Using dodge too much.
Look at my face.
I'm looking. Oh. What? I forgot that gave a delay. That was so close. Suffering is part of the immortal condition. The pain will never stop. Truth. Let's collect some blood. Got another 10 XP for dying. Honestly, best use of it. What? What? That takes my blood? I guess he's a vampire. Oh, fuck me, this is not going well. If we win this one, I'd be like... What? I'd be very surprised, let's just say that. Lock on. Block that hit. Heal.
Thou was never a vampire. I am now. I cannot.
Oh, shit. god, we did it. The shotgun came in so clutch. Treatment for headache. And a Thomas's cross. An item we could not have gotten otherwise. What a fight! Watery brisk blood sample. Very nice. Anything up here? Oh yeah. Yeah. Analyze, nothing to analyze, but we do have a treatment for headache. Recipe unknown. Cool. Still spooky noises. Pretty sure we killed everything. Unless we didn't.
It's locked.
Of course. Oh, hello. Sample. Cool. I hate how we just never win that trade. He goes for an attack, I try and stun, or attack. It's impossible to win. Ladies and gentlemen, we got him. Let's go. What a fight that was. I'm glad he's dealt with though. Now he won't come and bite us in the ass. Literally. So. We can remove that, and we need to go here, which means we need to go here. Doubled their patrols, haven't they?
I can't believe I'm doing this.
I can. So I told you to. Right. This is a very good way of going, it's a very sneaky way. We're right at the cemetery, eh? Have any bullets left? That's gonna hurt. I don't know why he wasn't aggroed. I'll complain. going? 180 meters that way. Is it through the cemetery? Surely not. I'm going just entirely the wrong direction. Unless I have a stupid marker there, don't I? We got like 1,000 XP or so from killing that Thomas guy. Wait, so then we've done this. No, it's not even here, it's the next one. Hey, what's up?
Good evening, Nurse Brannigan.
Good evening, Doctor.
Nothing else.
Goodbye, nurse. Call me if you need assistance.
Yeah, just call me on my phone. That I definitely have. Sorry, my directional sense is so bad. I have to check every like 2 seconds. There's a reverend up there. You know what? I don't have to deal with you and your stupid cross of death. I think I can go that way. Get some opium. I wonder if it's just on the street. Just some opium on the street. No, it isn't.
It's one of them vermin.
You can't beat my stamina bar. Is it this way? Nope. Get rid of that. We need to go here. Like there. Which is Fuck, how do I get that way? Oh, it's here, isn't it? Okay, back we go.
I'll kill you.
No, you won't. He tried. He really tried. Let's keep going.
Grenade?
Eating your friend? Straight across. Walk, thank you. Grenade. No, there isn't. Don't lie. We could go right just before. Up here. Oh my god, the controls after you go out from the map just lock. That's interesting, for sure. Let me go left. Oh, don't say it. Don't say it. Oh. Nice. And we hop across. And then we need to go here. fuck that. Oh. Beep. Oh my god, fuck. Shit. Bollocks. Balls. Ball sex.
The power of the Lord!
This is mine!
Yeah, let's just fucking leg it. Left. Doors didn't lock that time. I am eternally grateful. Oh, fuck off. Fuck off, can I not get past there?
Oh,
you're not even a proper, like, dude. Hey, nothing compared to the flamethrower dude I saw last time. Yeah. Shotgun shell. I tried to reload, but it automatically did it. Don't tell me it's that. I have a feeling it's that. I can't even get through there. Oh, yes I can. I lied. Oh yeah, this is the... That's the dude. That's the fucking dude.
It's locked.
And I can't get in from that side. Great. So... I have to go through because yep. Go through here, then you go down here, you go into the right, just put a marker here. Get rid of that one. Nothing to see here, buddy. Fight me. Do it. Oh, I'm dead. I'm dead. I'm not dead. Did it, okay. Beast down. Watery rich blood sample.
I have this thirst for blood.
I sure do. Oh no. I have to go in here. This is the guy I can't defeat. Well, I couldn't last time. Right. Fuck. fucking damage, dude. Get my stamina. And then dodge to the side. And then... we have to just kill him. We have no choice. Hide behind him. He can fire through it? It's the fucking guy with the gun. You know what? Undo that. And then... wait, it locks the fucking door? Oh, you are shitting me. We're gonna use our serums. We need to save our stamina for that shit. Stamina serum. Oh, what? I changed my gun for some reason. Don't want any of that. Thank you for asking though, you're very kind. All of your bloody leeches need killing. Oh, we did it! Don't get cocky. Yeah, he's doing his... hey, he's just melee. Gotta say, that level up from 12 to 15 basically allowed us to do this. That is insane. We did it. Holy moly. I can't believe it locked us in. Oh, progress.
The wounds on this corpse are deep, the result of rabid rage. If this is Sean's doing, he's become a murderous beast.
Mm-hmm. I believe it. Where do we go now? Okay. Yeah, we go out this way. No? This way? Yeah. What's that noise? I'm looking for loot. That got my heart beating. Yep, just walk into that. Cool. We can't go that way. This way? Whoosh. Oh, hello. Motherfucker. Got one bullet. I've just realised what our stash is. It's that box that lets us refill ammo. 30th manner where you die. Thank you. Can I unlock this? Nice. Rat. Very useful. Rats are invaluable. Eating rats doesn't like change your storyline, right? It's just useful. They are just a valuable resource.
I have this thirst for blood.
I know. Ain't it crazy? It's like you're a vampire or something. Curfew. Night shelters vicinity. We are here. It's straightforward. Oh, we can't get a weapon out here, which is a good sign. Means there might be people to talk to, and... No. Yes. Sweet. We have reached the next safe area. And gosh darn it, I think we deserve it. We did a good amount of fighting there. Very well-paced game, honestly. Hello, sir.
Good evening, Mr. Throckmorton.
Oh, it's Throckmorton.
Can I be of any assistance? Have you noticed anything suspicious lately?
Apart from myself, no. You already told me where Sean Hampton
and
is.
Good hunting, Mr. Throckmorton.
Or someone else did. I don't know. Well, it's like a hospital over here, too. So true.
It's locked, all right.
I wonder where we get all these keys from. Everything seems to be locked. Hello.
Good evening, miss. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. May I have your attention for a minute?
Good evening, sir. My name is Giselle Paxton.
Giselle Paxton.
But I don't have time for men like you.
Fair
have
enough.
You met before?
No. But I just need to look at your fancy clothes to know that you must be desperate to visit the docks at night.
That's quite judgmental of you.
Mm-hmm. So, I've led enough strikes when I had a job to identify you as an enemy of the working class.
Mm. Judging at first sight, huh?
Do
How
you
are
need
you?
Medical help, Miss Paxton?
No, thank you.
That's nice. What do you do?
What
well,
can you
wrong
tell
question.
Me about this vicinity?
Tell you what, just spend a few weeks here. And then ask me that question again.
Okay.
If you're still alive, I mean.
Okay. What? Say it. Just say it.
If you have something to say, say it. I'm getting tired of all this.
Oh. You want information?
No, I want opinion.
Well, here's some for you. Giselle Paxton does not like you at all, Doctor.
Well, that was kind of obvious.
You don't know me, Miss Paxton, and yet you see me as an enemy.
Your manners, your clothes, your words tell me everything about you, sir. I know your kind, and you don't belong here.
Oh no, Miss Paxton, you really don't know my kind. You have no idea who I am.
Making things worse.
Okay. I need to get all worked up.
Yeah, Jesus.
May I ask what you do for a living?
I'm killing myself scraping for a living. And you? Have you ever had to struggle in your entire life?
As I told you, I'm a doctor. You have to work a lot to earn that title.
Oh, a doctor. Born with money in a nice house, were we? Was Daddy a banker or a doctor himself?
It's a bit much. I get the idea, but it's a bit
Why
much on her part.
Are you judging me by my clothes?
Yeah, that's exactly what she's
I
doing.
Am. Fuck, you're so blind. You don't even see your privilege. Lazy people like you disgust me.
Lazy? Jeez Louise.
You speak of strikes and class enemy. Am I right to assume you're involved in trade union activism?
You bet I am. Well, I was. Nowadays, I'm just another worker blacklisted by the big companies.
Big pharma, eh?
Isn't the whole point of trade unions to help workers in need? Why don't they support you?
A few nights back, I lost the money my companions had asked me to hide.
Whoops.
With me and my sister being penniless, they thought I stole it.
What really happened?
I drank to...
Giselle has lost the money for the trade union she belongs to.
Much that night. Strange men saw me count the money in that bar. Some sort of militia in uniform. I'm sure they robbed me.
You lost your job because of your beliefs.
Those bastards really hate a worker who refuses slave wages and unsafe conditions, especially when it's a woman.
True enough.
I'm looking for Sean Hampton. Can you help me?
What is it you want? Does he owe you money? Has he displeased your Royal Highness? I'm no snitch, Mr. Fancy Pants.
Fair.
Well, I'll leave you for now. Goodbye, Miss Paxton.
What a person, eh? Now don't mind me whilst I rob a bit. You'll rob all the loot in the area. Back here. Let's like try and get the weapon out in case I need it. In case it's sort of like a telltale sign that you're about to fight enemies. Not bullets for the shotgun though. Hello.
Good evening, miss. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. Can I help you?
A fancy doctor lurking at night by the docks? Not fishy at all.
I see your
point.
And
what about you? Working outside at night in this dangerous part of town.
You want to know my secret? I'm trying to earn money. And I'm Lottie Paxton, by the way.
Hi, Lottie.
Is it not dangerous to work here at night?
As long as I have good legs, I can run away from trouble. The sad saint now provides me and my sister a bed and a roof. I don't want to lose that.
What can you tell me about the sad saint?
It's just the nickname of Sean Hampton, the sad saint of the East End. He gave me shelter, and he's not always sad.
You're a bit crazy if he was.
Are you homeless, Miss Paxton?
Mr. Hampton's night asylum is our new home now. It's a safe place for me and my sister.
Cool.
What can you tell me about this place? How are things here?
It may be okay for a strong girl like me, but a dandy doctor from the city like yourself. You better watch your back, Mr. Reed.
I'm all right, don't worry about me.
Which local dangers must I avoid?
Well, the gangs, the thieves, the drunks, the jobless. A man with your fancy clothes will attract a lot of attention.
Well, I am not someone so easily intimidated.
Glad to hear that. And if you get into trouble, you can always seek help at Sean Hampton's shelter. No one would dare to be violent there.
That's where I am.
You really think I should go back to a safer place?
No. I think you had better stay and help as many people as you can.
Mm-hmm.
Just avoid the wet boot boys. Those bastards are worse than the epidemic.
I haven't heard good things.
I'm looking for Sean Hampton. Can you help me?
Mr. Hampton must be in his office at the night asylum he manages.
You mean the one we're in?
Why do you want to see him?
He was a patient of mine at the Pembroke Hospital, but he left abruptly.
I see. Well, Mr. Hampton is a discreet and dedicated man. I'm sure you'll find him soon enough.
Goodbye, Miss Paxton.
She was nicer than the other lady.
This Seymour worries me. Sean knows something about him.
Seymour. Handwritten prayer. Dear Lord. Amen. The bomb exploded just after dawn in front of Dawson and Dawson Munitions Factory. Oof. The largest employer in the district. The detonation smashed all the windows of all the factories in North Southwark. It's a miracle only two people died in the attack, confirmed Chief Superintendent Alexander Brayton.
It's locked, all right.
It sure is. I see stuff in the form of a trash can. Sorry, rubbish bin. I am British, after all. Miss Paxton, I recently heard... Which one? I recently heard Hampton's shelter for months and money or support of any kind. Without a positive answer from you, I may be... My boys always get what they... Accepting no answer. Keep on refusing to answer me and... Wet boot boys come... You and your sister. Okay. Lucky Paxton. They're poor and homeless since their mother died. Always refused to help the wet boot boys despite their threats. Good for you, Lottie. Should talk to her after we do with we do the things that we gotta do here. It's down there. I wonder. Some stuff and some things. Hell yeah. Me a good shotgun. Upstairs, I guess. Oh, nice. Hello. Ink pen. That looked like the office. No. down. Ooh. Oh, you're just reflecting light. Okay. You tricked me. Maybe up here? Ooh, stuff.
Come now, Lottie. There is still much work to do.
Hey, Lottie.
Glad to see you again, Mr. Reed.
Lottie, tell me about the Wet Boot Boys. I know they've threatened you.
Edwina Cox wanted me to provide her with information about Mr. Hampton's resources. I refused.
Is that not dangerous?
Fuck them and their lies.
True.
They claim they protect the interests of the neighborhood, but they are just greedy parasites like all the rest.
Yeah.
I respect your courage, Miss Paxton. And I hope life will never wear you down.
Dr. Reed, you know how to make a girl blush. I am glad you came to the docks, whatever your real reasons are.
Lottie, tell me about the death of your mother.
Giselle killed her.
Giselle.
Plain and simple. She killed her with her daily whims, her laziness, and her complaints.
That's quite a statement. You can't kill someone because you're fickle.
Mother was very ill, but I forgave Giselle. What I couldn't stand was how she cried at her funeral like she was the one left alone.
Perhaps your sister is not as tough as
her sister.
I know that, and I don't blame her.
Oh, the one outside.
It just makes me sad that my own sister is the person I understand the least.
Aww. Why not forgive her?
Giselle is the only family you have left. Don't you think it's time?
He's so
Sometimes
fucking
words
nosy.
Are harder to forgive than acts, Dr. Reed.
You're just like a doctor vampire, and you're like the biggest gossip in the entire freaking city. Oh, maybe in here. Hey.
Why the long face, Doctor?
Oh, look at his eyes. He's been killing. I mean, look at mine, and look at his. He's gone way further down the rabbit hole than I have. Yes, we have both changed a lot.
It looks like we both have changed a lot. I must confess, it saddens me, Sean.
Put your faith in the Lord, Doctor. He has a plan for all of us. We may not always see it, but he does.
Since you left Pembroke, the amount of blood that has been shed, it's hard to believe you, Sean.
Ask what you will. As the Lord is my shepherd, I will not speak a lie to you.
Okay.
Why return here?
This is my home.
Okay.
These people are my flock. You will always find me where I am needed.
Remember the guy you killed?
And what about William Bishop? He tried to take care of you. But this hunger, this thirst, cannot be restrained.
Alas, poor William. He had a good soul, but was weak in spirit. He could not shake the thirst for booze, never mind blood. But have faith. My will is far stronger than his.
That wasn't, like, that wasn't even close to, like, regret.
Wonders never cease. Scowl managing an asylum.
And what of you? A vampire doctor? Meals laid out before you? Yet you restrain?
Yeah, kind of.
Aren't you afraid of what you've become?
We are blessed, Doctor. Can't you see it? The Lord has made us able to walk amongst the plague and aid those that need it.
What does that mean? Let's not egg him on.
Do you think this is a blessing when God's own house and holy symbols repel you?
If that is your burden, Doctor, so be it. But I do not fear the cross.
I mean, it's not really a choice.
Nor am I forced to take the life of another. My kind doesn't
share
your
imperfections.
Oh, so
you did it, like, willingly, huh?
But you must drink blood now to survive.
Oh.
Know not your scripture. Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life. And I will raise him up at the last day, so saith the Lord. I only need to eat flesh, no blood.
What? So, are they not like the same thing? You killed her.
Why did you kill Miss Jones at the Pembroke Hospital?
Killed old Harriet? You must be mad, Doctor. Why would I do such a thing?
Wait, so... you're innocent?
So you claim Miss Jones' death was not by your hand, nor the other incidents at Pembroke?
Though Harriet was an angry, spiteful woman, she was one of God's creatures. I have nothing but love for all he has made.
But you were close to her.
Of course. But she was lost, separated from the fold. She did not see the hand of the divine in my blessed condition.
Yeah, I'm honestly not convinced at all.
People have been murdered. I've seen the blood. I don't believe you can be trusted.
Have a little faith, Doctor. If you will follow, I will guide you to the light.
How do you plan to do that?
Take this key of the old sewers. The entrance is by the riverbank, south from here. There you'll find all the proof you need.
Okay. I'm intrigued.
Very well. You have definitely intrigued me. I hope you're right, Sean.
I'll be here with
his eyes, though.
If you still think I'm a threat, then, well, I'll surrender myself to your judgment.
Thanks for the stuff, I guess. Paper. Confess, sometimes I wish I never saved Dyson Delany from drowning when he fell in the canal. I like him, honestly. I like Dyson. He's a bit, like, lost. He's a good guy. Dyson may be the most frustrating case I ever had to deal with since I opened the night shelter in the East End. For years I tried to understand why this man regularly makes me so irritated, and I think recently I found out why. Dyson has stopped fighting, for good and forever. I've met so many heavy drinkers in my life, men and women, rich and poor, young and old. I've witnessed their fight with their demons, their past, their guilt, and their failures. Sometimes they can put a name on this inner evil of theirs, sometimes they have never been able to identify the real cause of their despair. But in most cases, for these men and women, to drink is a way to keep fighting. Of course, it is a useless and destructive form of struggle, but at least this self-destruction means that something makes them suffer, and they still fight against this pain they feel so deep inside. Even a severe alcoholic like William Bishop keeps struggling with his addiction and asking for a salvation for the light of Christ. And as long as they wish to see this light, there is a place for hope. Dyson Delany has no hope left. He does not drink to smother his pain, no. I'm now convinced he conscientiously drinks for the sadist joy of smothering all hope. I really don't know what is the worst sin. To deliberately cast away hope from your own heart, or complacently bask in self-destruction. I mean, that's just like your opinion, man. Got a new thing for Dyson, though. Is that him complete? Monsieur Dyson. Nope. Be cool to go talk to him though. Right. Explore the sewers. Oh god, we're gonna end up fighting some beastie, aren't we? Oh dear, oh dear. Is it even... what? How do you go that way? Oh. Like this. Lower Thames Bank. Let's call that episode there. We'll go find... that was a cool landing. We'll go find the sewer later. And thanks for joining me, guys. See you next time and take care.